Hallöchen everyone and welcome to my first video on this channel. As you can see, we are opening a art subscription box named Upgrade. It's from Germany and this one is from February 2021. It's my first box and we will see what's inside. Please let me know if you knew this box before this video or if you already saw it somewhere else or maybe bought it yourself and what you think about it. First, there is this little tissue paper wrapping with the items we received. Then you can see there is a little magazine, but we don't look at it because it will spoil the items. And yeah, I think it's better to first see what the items are and then you can read about them in the magazine. So first I'm going to open the tissue paper wrapping, so we will see what's inside the box and try them out. So here are the items, and the first one we get is an acrylic marker from the company Loop, I think, and it has a very wide tip. As you can see now, you have to activate it before, that's why the tip is very yellow and not red, and it's water based. Next we have two charcoal pencils, one in black and the other one in white. They are from the brand Koi E Noir, and I think that the pencils is very cool because usually when you work with charcoal, your hands can get very dirty. Now we have the main item, I would say. These are soft petals from the brand Rembrandt, and I never used soft petals before. This is the set muted colors, so they are more like earthy and light colors. As we can see, the top row is light colors and the bottom is very earthy, like greens and browns. There's no true black, the darkest color is very dark green. And this blue one here is my favorite from all of them. It's very light and very pretty. So now that we looked at every item that was in a tissue paper, we can have a look at the magazine. At the first pages you can see the items that are in the box, but on the next page we can see there is actually paper, and I totally forgot to look at this, so we will see what the rest of the items are in the box first. First we have this little sheet with stickers, and my favorite one is the one with the cat, because I love cats. In every upgrade there is a featured artist, and this is this month's picture. It's a very abstract picture, personally not my style that I like, but I think the picture is beautiful. Now we have the paper. It's a toned drawing paper, also from Rembrandt, and it's especially made for the soft petals, so it worked really good together. It's 20% recycled and made of 50% cotton. Now we can get to the swatching. First I choose to swatch the acrylic marker because I was very interested in it, but as you can see now, my cat Moon decided to sit on my supplies and didn't leave me alone. Then I decided, who cares, he can sit a little bit there and watch me swatching the items. The camera is very wobbly because of my cat. I hope that's not too disturbing for you, but in a few seconds he decided to jump off the table. So as I said earlier, the acrylic marker has to be activated by pushing the nib on the paper and shaking it a little bit, so the paint can flow in the nib and then you can use the marker. The color of the marker is a very nice bright red. It is a very good contrast to the light and earthy colors from the soft petals, and because of the tip of the marker you can draw very thick lines but also very thin detailed lines. Next, I tried out the black charcoal pencil and I really liked it because it's more precise than a normal charcoal piece. And I don't use charcoal often because I don't like the feeling from it in my hands and the powder, and your hands get so dirty. But this pencil is obvious not doing that because the wood is outside. And the white one I also really like because the white is very bright and on the paper you can really, really see it. This white pencil is also very helpful for details in hair or eyes, and I will definitely use it in my future drawings. So last, we are going to swatch the soft petals. I'm really excited to see all the colors on the toned paper. I think the toned paper is helping the light colors to show more up and making the colors more intensive. I really like that. I think on white paper the colors would be a little more dull. But I think also that the colors on black paper would also be really awesome. So, now that we swatched all items, let's see what I can create with them. So first I wasn't sure what I wanted to draw, but I sketched a little bit and decided to draw a mask with some plants in the background. First I used the red acrylic marker for my background, but I shaked it a little too much and it leaked all over my page and my table, but it wasn't too bad because I filled the background anyways with the red. I totally forget to talk earlier about the artist. The artist's name is Eleanor Shapiro. She's a 23-year-old artist and you can find her on Instagram. Please have a look at her. I used a white charcoal pencil to sketch out my drawing, and now you can see the time lapse of my process. First I used brown color and I used a cotton swab to blend the pigment more into the paper. I just shaked off the extra pigment. Then I used the yellow color to make stripes that imitate a wood texture on the mask. I colored the big leaves with the lightest green, and later I colored the little leaves behind them with the darkest color in the set and shaded it with a little bit of yellow. And of course, I blended everything also with a cotton swab. In general, my idea with this mask was that if you lay a paper on one side, the other half is happy and the other half is sad. And one thing I didn't know, on the back of the magazine from the box, there is a little topic you can use every month, and I totally didn't see that, but next month I will try to interpret the topic in my drawing. Because I wasn't happy how the brown looked on the red, more like a skin tone I would say, I cheated a little bit and used some old chalk for me. I hope that's okay. Next time I will try to use only the items in the box. This was my very first time working with soft pastels, and I didn't look up how to work with them. I just jumped in the experience and enjoyed drawing my picture. I think for my first time it worked really well and the picture looks great. But I will definitely look up how to use them right, and if you have any tips and know how to use them, just write it down in the comments. I will definitely look it up, and maybe you can help me with this new art supply. So, this is my finished drawing with the items I received. I hope you liked the video. Please give me feedback in the comments. I'm really appreciating this, and I will see you next time.